Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. We're here in New York City, the greatest city on earth, my city, in Times Square, here to bring you all the latest dev news. As always, I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Developer Advocate, and let's get into it. First things first, Microsoft Build is coming. Yes, we've said it before, we're going to say it again. It's taking place between May 7th and May 9th, 2018, in Seattle, Washington, the second best city on earth. Be sure to register now, and I'm going to be there. All your Channel 9 favorites will be there. We want to see you there. Next up, Microsoft Teams has a great new feature. Finally, it has guest access. What does this mean? This means that if you want to invite someone into your Teams group who is not in your Active Directory, you can do that. Just add in their email address. They will get permissions to access your Teams stuff. This is a great feature that I've been waiting for a long time. Check it out. Next up, in very cool news, Microsoft Genomics, which is a platform that powers genetic analysis of personalized medicine, is now generally available. And this is actually part of a bunch of announcements that Microsoft has made this week around healthcare. And the Genomics platform basically it's cool. I don't understand all of it. All I know that it's cool. It's in general availability. You can do stuff in the cloud. I love it. Next up, on Channel 9 this week, be sure to check out the latest episode of Five Things. This time, John Papa interviews Anders Helsberg, who is the inventor of TypeScript, about what else? TypeScript. So if you want to learn five of the coolest things you can do with TypeScript, check it out. Also on Channel 9 this week, check it out. That's my face. Yes, I interviewed Ruth Yakubu, a senior cloud developer advocate at Microsoft, who has a great history about how she got interested in tech, her course from being a solutions architect to now being a cloud architect, a cloud advocate, how she uses Java and AI together. It's a great interview. Check it out. Thank you, Ruth, for being my guest. Next up, the UWP Community Toolkit is now at version 2.2. And this is all community driven. A lot of suggestions come from the community. And some of the great new features include new Microsoft parser support, as well as markdown support for inline text blocks. There's a lot of really cool features. Nicola, who's one of our Channel 9 favorites, has the release notes up. Check it out. Also new this week is .NET Core 2.1 and ASP.NET Core 2.1 are now in public preview version 1. If you're interested in providing feedback, the team really wants to know your thoughts, so be sure to check that out. One note on that is that you can develop .NET Core 2.1 apps with Visual Studio 2017, 15.6 Preview 6 and higher, or in VS Code. In some of the other platforms, you might need to wait a little bit longer, but this is all coming along really, really well. Next up, in Xamarin news, UrhoSharp, which is a .NET API for building 3D experiences, is now at version 1.8. And there are a bunch of new things added in this release, including inverse kinematics, bullet ray cast vehicle support, and much more. UrhoSharp is very cool. Check out Miguel's blog post for more information. And if you want to do 3D stuff that can work cross-platform, be sure to check this out. Next up, everybody's favorite developer, Scott Hanselman, has a really good post on his blog about how to use URL overwriting middleware to upgrade an old website. He basically goes through the process of tanking his podcast website, which is like 10 years old. He's updating it to run on more modern frameworks, but at the same time, he doesn't want to break URLs. So using the URL rewriting middleware, he can do that so that old links don't break, but new links look pretty. And as somebody who's a big advocate for keeping links accurate across the web and not breaking links, I love the tutorial and love that Scott did it. Thank you, Scott. Finally, it is time for my pick of the week. And this one is from my friend Andrew over at Gizmodo. He found this amazing video. The title of this post is, "I feel like I'm part of this jazz band captured with a depth sensing Microsoft Kinect camera." Now look, the Microsoft Kinect might be dead, and we're all very sad about that because it's really cool. But filmmakers are still doing amazing things with it, including this video where people are basically recording, using the depth sensing camera to record a jazz band and make a great film. You've got to see the video. It's on the post. It's so good. I love it. So check that out. Well, that does it for me this week in Times Square. I think I'm gonna go get some Shake Shack or something. I don't know. Make sure you like and subscribe Microsoft Developers at the bottom if you like us, and leave a comment. Tell us what you like, what you don't like, and turn on notifications so you can be alerted to all the great dev content we do. See you next time.